You said you did it at D.
The man usually has a band.
Okay.
I've been talking to him.
No.
Just let me know.
He's a one-man band.
Thank you.
Okay, anybody else need a bulletin? Joyce, come on back here, you guys. Don't be shy. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to worship here in the Memorial Garden. Our two churches are now gathering here for most of August, except August 20th at 11 a.m. We will be having a picnic at the Black Rock State Park in Thomaston. If you would like to sign up so we can get an idea of how many people are coming, there's a sign-up sheet inside there, so just come on in for coffee hour. And if you're thinking of coming, sign up. They don't care so much about signing up what you're going to bring, but if they could get a rough count, that would be great. The Lutherans are sponsoring that picnic for us. Okay, let us start with joys and concerns.
Can you hear me?
I can hear
okay.
You.
Prayers for Nora German. Her parents are friends of us. She's 3 months old and had an operation this week to untangle her intestines.
Oh my God.
It appears that everything went well last time I talked to her father, but she's gonna have a little bit of a recovery time.
Other joys and concerns. The joy to be worshiping with Sunny the puppy. Probably be seeing more of her. Any other, yes.
Joyce for Kenny for cleaning up our garden and raking it to make sure we don't get grass between our toes.
And Carol Ferland continues at home with a broken arm. So continued prayers for her. Janet Rinko as well sees the doctor again on Wednesday. Okay, announcements. Do we have any announcements? Yes.
I've got the sign-up sheets for the Terryville Fair, the 25th, 26th, 27th. I have them in my car if anybody wishes to sign up. And you also need baked goods for that time.
Okay, anybody else have announcements? I already announced the August 20th event.
You said that was 11, right?
11 a.m., so you get to sleep in. You just don't forget it all together.
Blueberry dinner?
Blueberry pancakes are this Wednesday, 6 p.m. It's our regular dinner church, except we'll be having blueberry pancakes, sausages, and the trimmings. So if you like blueberry pancakes, definitely show up for that. Okay, looks like we're ready for our opening hymn, which is printed on the bulletin insert. Together in a spirit of prayer, beginning with a time of silent prayer and reflection. Holy God, we come to you today with gratitude and joy for the warmth of this sunshine and this fellowship. We thank you for each person who has come here. May each one of us find what it is that we are seeking in this company this morning. We ask you to touch each heart and mind. be with us, show us your ways, inspire us with our time of worship and with the setting of the worship. We offer these prayers in the name of Jesus. Amen. Now let us have a prayer for those who need our joys and concerns. Loving God, we ask you to be with all of those lifted up in our time of joys and concerns. Be with little Nora, who is 3 months old, with Carol and Janet, who are healing, with all of those who are not mentioned in our prayers. We thank you for this garden and for the hands that have worked on it, for Kim. We thank you that we have new life in our midst in the form of a puppy. And we ask you to be with Jessica as she embarks on a new life. We offer these prayers in the name of Jesus. Amen. All right, hymn number 2. Pass it on. Reading comes from the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 14, starting with verse 13. Now, when Jesus heard this, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, they need not go away. You give them something to eat. They replied, we have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, bring them here to me. Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds, and all ate and were filled. And they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. Here ends the reading. Does anybody have any jokes to share before we get started?
Don't you have your dad?
My dad jokes I left in the car. You got jokes for me, Bernie?
Yeah, I have some.
All right. Do you want me to read it or are
yes,
you going to read it?
Okay.
Oh, I had that one. I have another it walks into a bar joke, too. I was going to share. I forgot I was going to share that one. My paper airplane won't fly. It's completely stationary. Dove chocolate tastes way better than their soap. A mushroom walks into a bar. Bartender says, we don't serve your kind, mushroom. Says, why not? I'm a fun guy. I have another one. A piece of string walks into a bar. Bartender says, we don't serve your kind. So the string goes outside and starts kicking stuff and gets all like tangled up and stuff and gets real mad and comes back and he says, I want milk in a dirty glass. And the bartender says, aren't you that piece of string that was just in here? And he said, I'm afraid not. So bad it's good. Thank you, Bernie.
Better save those for Reverend Dash.
You always have some. I don't know. It's like you have like a magic well where the dad jokes come from.
It's called the internet.
It's called the internet. The internet is good for looking at cats and dad jokes. And that's about it. Today's scripture lesson is known as the feeding of the 5,000, which actually it's the feeding of the 5,000 plus, because they did not mention how many women and children are there. But if you figure, you know, there may be one woman and multiple child, it could have been 10,000 or more. And it is a story that is found in each of the 4 Gospels of Jesus taking a small amount of food and somehow miraculously feeding a huge crowd with it. It's obviously an extremely popular story. Many soup kitchens and food pantries are named after this passage. They call themselves loaves and fishes. There are ministries that are, you know, named for this passage of scripture. And it is sort of the impetus for Christians to make sure that everyone gets enough to eat, that everyone is well fed. And there are some theories about this passage of scripture because it doesn't really tell us how everyone was fed. There are some who speculate that some of the people brought food with them and some of the people didn't. Now I have, in researching for other sermons, learned that the fishes in question were kind of poor people food that was pretty common. Most likely they were salted fish, preserved by salt, which is something that people still do today. They preserve fish in salt and they kind of dry them. And I'm not fond of them, but my son thinks they're the greatest thing ever and he eats them. And when he was a kid, I would be like, you can't eat them in the car when I'm in the car. Cause to me, it would smell up the whole car. But for some people, that's, you know, it's a staple food for them. They love it. And so that's probably how there were fishes in this hot day that were not like stinking to high heaven, relatively speaking. They just smelled like, you know, ordinary fish. And so that is probably what it was. So it's possible. possible that the people weren't sharing with each other, and as Jesus passed them out, then people kind of opened their hearts and they shared what they had. Or it could have been a miracle. It doesn't say this is a miracle and the fishes magically, as you broke them, there were more and more. It doesn't tell us what happened. But we do know from other passages of scripture in the early church, when they had communion, they generally did it the way that we do our dinner church, which is people brought their food and they made a day of it. They had house church worship, which a lot of people, when you think of a house church, you think like your house, and there was a few people there, but actually it tended to be wealthy people's homes with a big courtyard, and so a lot of people would be there, and it would be kind of like this in a way. You know, these are technically different buildings, but it's all part of the same area and part of the same complex. And so they would bring their food, and then they would have communion. And there was some problems with some people bringing lots of lavish food and eating in front of the poor people. And so they were admonished by early church leaders that if they were going to bring a lot of food and fancy wines and things, that they shouldn't sit there and like be gluttons and get drunk, that they should share, that we should share with one another. And so that's what we do. We share with one another. We bring things to our dinners. We have potlucks. We have coffee hours. And we share with one another. And then we also have ministries that are all about sharing food with one another. And not just like leftover dregs food, but we share what we have. Some of the things we share are basic staples. And then last week we had a plea from our food pantry for some kids' cereal, some cereal that kids like to eat. And that's kind of special, you know? It's nice to share good times and bad times, share the special. That's what community is all about. It's about sharing. And I'm a person that really believes in loaves and fishes, kind of literally. And it kind of got me in trouble a few months ago. Some of you were there. We have a Wednesday night supper, and usually we make too much, and then we package up leftovers, and people take leftovers home. And that's fine. We don't know exactly how many people are coming. We know kind of. But this particular night, it was a worship service for the longest night of the year. And following the service, the dinner church service, we had a service of prayer and healing for the longest night. And I figured it would be like some previous years, people would come just for the service and some people would come for both. And some people would come just for the dinner. Well, everybody came for the dinner. And so those who came late, we kind of ran out of soup, and I was like unfreezing cheese and crackers and bread and making toasted, you know, cheese on toast, because I've always said, you know, somehow God will provide, but God, I should have been more faithful in beforehand making a plan so that God could provide. But I mean, nobody went away hungry, because, you know, loaves and fishes is real, but you know, we're not Jesus, and we have to think about this. We can't just spontaneously, on the spur of the moment, very easily take care of people. So we need to be mindful of it. We need to remember that the food pantry has needs year-round. The soup kitchens have needs year-round. People with needs don't stop having needs because they're out of our sight and out of our mind. I remember some years ago, one of the families in our church, the DuPonts, they talked to the food pantry and they said, is there a time when you don't get quite enough donations? And they said, well, really kind of the March was not a great time. So they would go, and you might remember them doing this, sit in front of the supermarkets with a table on the weekends and get people to buy food and donate it. And they did this for many years. I guess right now our food pantry is pretty well blessed with enough donations. Most of the time, there may be some shortages that some of our folks could speak to how we are doing in terms of our donation. But I think that all of us at one time or another have had times when we have more than enough. And all of us at one time or another have had times when we go into our cupboards and we're looking in the back and we're like, oh, I guess I could put this and this together and that would be an okay dinner. And so it's good to be mindful and generous and to count our blessings when we have our blessings, and also to share our blessings when we have our blessings. And those of us who are struggling, don't be shy, you know? That's what our food pantry is for. That's what our churches are for. If you're hungry, we have a lot of people who will help you. And if you're having trouble cooking because of a physical illness or infirmity that's temporary, you know, we can help you with that. And if it's more long term, there are programs for that. So don't be shy. Make sure you ask. Jesus wanted to feed the people, not just their bodies, but their souls, because he understood that the body and the soul are connected. That is the Jewish belief, that it's not that you have a body and a soul, but that you are a body and a soul. And when we break bread together, that is a sacred moment, as we're about to do here, and then later in coffee hour. It's a sacred moment. It's a moment that connects us. We don't just share food. We share the Holy Spirit. We share the body of Christ. And that's important, and that's meaningful. And by sharing the body of Christ, we become the body of Christ in the world today. And that's a profound moment. So as we enter into our time of communion, let us bear in mind that we're sharing the body of Christ, and we are becoming the body of Christ, and we are the body of Christ. And we may not be perfect, but we can be enough. Amen.
Amen.
And now I would invite the deacons to come forward for our time of Holy Communion. We have an open table here, so if you feel moved to participate, you can. We do invite people to eat the bread as they receive it, and then we hold on to the cup, and then when I give the signal, you can drink the cup. Also, if you hadn't noticed, we don't do a regular offering. We have a little box, so if you put your money in the box, if it's loose bills, we split them between the two churches. If it's got the name on an envelope or on a check, we make sure it goes where it's supposed to go. Now let us join together in our service of Holy Communion. You'll find it on the back of the song sheet. May God be with you.
May God also be with you.
People of God, open up your hearts.
We open them to God and one another.
Give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks to the one who offers us lives filled with grace.
When we are children, we run footloose through grace. You love us, tender God, dappling the night skies with the bright stars of morning, teaching us to walk the paths of that first dawn, telling us of your dream for all you created. When, in our hurry to greet you, we sometimes fall skinning our knees, you lift us up in your arms, holding us to your cheeks wet with joy. When we miss your calling us to wash us up for dinner, you come and find us, taking us by the hand to feed us from Eden's abundance. But sometimes, those of us who are grown-ups think we know more than you, turning to the idols of wealth and power, who promised to serve us even as they shackled us, giving ourselves over to anxiety's sweet caress. Yet you are God, not a few foolish human. You remain in our midst, not to punish or destroy, but to reach out and bring us home to your heart. Therefore, we joyfully lift our voices with those who have gone before us and those who stand beside us, singing our praise for your great love.
Holy, 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 God of steadfast love, all creation thanks you for your wonderful works. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes to lead us by a straight way. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, God of infinite tenderness, and blessed is Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord and Savior, breaking the bonds of sin. He binds our wounds with cords of compassion. Walking with us when we had lost our way, he shows us the paths to the kingdom. Stripping himself of glory and honor, he clothes us in the new life of faith. Leaving aside his equality with you, he became one of us, so that we might be one with you, remembering that you did not give up on us or hand us over to sin and death, but showered us with your mercy in Christ Jesus. We take the bread of life and the cup of grace and joyfully celebrate that mystery we call faith.
Christ died, his life hidden in God. Christ was raised to be seated by God's side. Christ will come again that we might be revealed with him in glory.
As we gather, we remember that on the last night of Jesus' earthly life before the crucifixion, he gathered with his friends in a room, and he took bread, and he blessed it, and he broke it, and he gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, broken for you." After supper, he took the cup, and having poured it, he blessed it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sin. Compassionate God, pour out your gracious spirit upon us, and on these, your simple gifts, fill us with the broken bread that we may be made whole. Touch our parched lips with the cup of salvation, so that we might proclaim your gospel. Then send us forth, our hearts recoiling at the oppression suffered by our sisters and brothers, our hands willing to build shelter for those cast out by the world, our arms surrounding the lost and the least in the embrace of common humanity. And when we are clothed with our new self, when we are united with our sisters and brothers gathered around the table of glory, we will sing our praises to you forever, God in community, holy in one, as you satisfy the thirsty with your grace and fill the hungry with your love. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Ministering to you in Christ's name, we now offer you this bread. If you have not done so, take and eat. This is the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Ministering to you in Christ's name, we now offer you this cup. This is the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Let us drink. Please join with me with the prayer after communion printed in our bulletin. Let us go with God to offer life to those around us.
We will gather up the broken to offer them healing.
Let us go with Jesus to wrap people in hope.
We will reach out to feed the hungry and shelter the homeless.
Let us go with the Spirit to love all those in our midst who have been forgotten.
We will take them in our arms and welcome them to our hearts.
So now is our final hymn, and this is a participatory moment. So we have some instruments here.
Feel free. Yeah, all kinds of fun stuff in there. Hands are full. Else. I'm going to leave it right here.
I'm going inside. I'm going to copy it.
Thank you.
Don't be shy, guys. Come on up and get some to play. I also have some sticks here. Worshipped, remain with us. as we leave this place. Go in peace. Amen.
Amen.
Join us. We do have air conditioning.